At Perth Airport, the welcoming committee was out in force as loved ones were reunited. For some, the border opening came too late.
I missed my daughter Lena. I was supposed to give away. That was hard. And then they opened the borders 10 days later.
For others, it was just in time.
I'm just so thankful to the WA Premier because I was absolutely elated on Monday when I heard them come over. So my dad died on Sunday night, so I'm very thankful to be here for the funeral.
Hello, Sarah.
For the first time in 8 months, travellers from Victoria and New South Wales were allowed to enter the wildflower state without a mandatory 14-day quarantine, but with the completion of a health screening.
We're very grateful that we were just one of the lucky ones.
I hope that those families enjoy the reunion and there's much love and excitement and happiness amongst families.
And good news for South Australians too. From Friday, they can enter WA as long as they quarantine. And from Saturday, Adelaideans will be welcomed back in Queensland so long as there's no outbreak in coming days.
This has been able to occur because of the great work that South Australia has been doing and that we have seen no unlinked cases over that period.
But after overseeing the longest border closure in the country, WA Premier Mark McGowan warned things will slam shut again in a heartbeat.
We're not out of the woods yet, and if we need to put the hard border back up in the future, we will.
As for today, just over 2 weeks out from Christmas, Australians from east to west...
Yeah, west is best.
...feeling relief and joy at the end of a tough year.
It was actually a really big year for us too, because my daughter turned 21, mum turned 80, my brother turned 50, my dad's partner turned 70, my brother-in-law turned 50.
Where were
all
we?
All this year.
Well, I missed it all. What can I say? I'm home,
Wow. And what a roll call of milestones that family has.
It's just yes.
Extraordinary. Yeah. It is great, this feeling that the country is almost back together again. There's still the quarantining for South Australia, WA. But the question I then have, like I've been thinking about this a lot with holidays coming up, is are you prepared to go, say, to WA? Knowing that the border could come up again at any moment, like those people from South Australia that landed in WA and then were told they'd have to quarantine because there was an outbreak. Like, are you prepared to trust that this is it?
We've I guess it's a state that, you know, as Mark McGowan has said, he's not afraid to close them. So from logistically planning a holiday, if you want to go to Perth in February, it's maybe at the back of your mind a little bit.
But you know what, though? International travel's been canned.
Yes.
So people on either side of the country might go, OK, we can't head overseas, but we can head a far distance away, which is, you know, East Coast if you're West Coast and West Coast if you're East Coast. Yeah. So it might be the substitute to international travel,
so
potentially.
Just as far as you possibly can. I mean, you could just ask the plane to collapse for a bit if you want.
Because, you know, West Australians, I know you guys, you would prefer to go to Bali than to come to Sydney, but you don't have a choice anymore. So maybe they have to come to Sydney.
It's true.
Well, people were out rejoicing in Perth today as the borders reopened, and this gentleman was so happy to be there, he might have just, well, he might have put himself in jeopardy.
Making him stay home from now on.
I've got a quarantine for 14 days. You probably shouldn't even be talking to me.
No, and you've got to have your mask on, please, mate.
And I've got to have my mask on.
There we go.
We've been told.
Can you come back over here?
Oh, no.
And this just in, borders have closed again.
Oh, no,
as a result of that man.
Oh, I'm so glad we caught it on camera.
With so much content online, it's sometimes hard to keep up with it all. And let's face it, who has the time? The project YouTube has you covered with the stories that matter. Hit subscribe for a daily list of the news that you need to know.